No, they're on VHS, not Betamax. It's great. You're gonna love it. Oh, they're here. Gotta go. Bye. Just got a new phone. Hi, welcome to the Online Jewelry Academy. I'm Professor John Ahr, and I'm your instructor. In this video, I'm gonna give you some information to follow up on information that was given to you in previous videos that were on chain making and how to coil jump rings to connect jewelry elements. Now, if you haven't seen those videos, you might want to pause here and go back and watch those videos first. That way, this video will make more sense. So, this video is going to center on the use of older technology, because sometimes the old things are great and they work so well, and there's no improving on them. What we're going to use is I'm going to use a wide blue painter's tape along with a paint stir stick. Now, this idea came to me from my colleague at the Fashion Institute of Design and Merchandising in Los Angeles. Professor Robert Ackerman was an apprentice in a goldsmith studio in Switzerland. Say that 10 times real fast. Anyway, he showed me how you can coil a wire on a mandrel so that you maintain the annealed quality of the jump rings and you get perfectly matched jump rings that have the same interior and exterior dimensions, which can be really important if you're making a precision piece of jewelry. So let me show you how to do it. So we cut slats from our paint stir stick and applied the blue painter's tape to them and then inserted them into the clamp-on bench vise. And this basically covers the jaws so that we're not going to mar our metal. Next, put on your safety glasses because you're working with wire. And what you want to do is pick up your wire and you're going to insert the wire in between the jaws. And then you're going to just close the vise, not so much that you're pinching the wire, but you want to be able to freely move it up and down, but have it also hold its position if you let go. Now that's perfect. Then what you're going to do is you'll pick up your coiling tool. You'll insert one end of the wire into the coiling tool, and then you'll come and make your first twist. But you want to pull the end of the wire that's hanging below the vise. Once you've got that in place, then you're slowly going to start to coil on top of the coiling tool. Now, a benefit to this process is that you don't work harden the wire at all, like you might if you pulled on the wire as shown in the previous video. What you're doing is you're maintaining the annealed quality of the metal so that these jump rings will not spring open when you finish coiling on your tool. They will just sit in place perfectly, and that's what helps to maintain their perfect matching interior and exterior dimensions. Okay, so that's enough. I think you get the point. So you can see if I release the coil by just clipping it, I can now move the coil freely along the tool so that I can cut the individual jump rings. Now, here's another tip. If you're having trouble removing the coil from the mandrel, or let's say that you're using a different style of mandrel, maybe you're using an old file where you've removed the teeth and you're coiling oval jump rings on that, but the coil is sticking. A way to ameliorate that problem is to apply one of these. Now, I'm not sure what these were originally made for. I believe they're for the jewelry industry because they fit our tools so perfectly. Now, you're going to remove one leaf from the package, and then you're going to just moisten the glue. Then you'll apply this to your mandrel and place the mandrel on top of a flat surface like your bench and turn to the right the way the industry always likes you to turn. And you're ready to coil on top of the paper. Now, this paper will give you a little bit of distance that should make it possible to freely move the coil once you're finished coiling onto your mandrel. I hope you like this tip. I sure do. And thank you to Professor Ackerman for providing it. You can find more great tips like this on our website at onlinejewelryacademy.com. If you like the video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. You can also find us on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. Thanks for watching.